Chewy, is that you?
All right, let's look at Chennedy Carter by the numbers. So in her career, she's averaging 22.5 points a game, 4 boards, 4 assists, shooting 43% from the field, 34% from 3, 74.8% from the free throw line. So as you can see, it's not like she's an elite shooter, but she's a great scorer. And we're going to talk about why she's a great scorer. If you look at her stats, her three-point percentage for her career is typically low 30s, which in college is decent. If you look at her WNBA numbers, she also didn't shoot too well from the three-point line in her WNBA career. And I think that's the transition from going to college to the pros. You know, you see her 3 points attempted. She started at 2 per game. She was shooting a high percentage. Her second year with the Dream, she's only attempting maybe 1 3 a game, shooting 11% from the three. You see just this previous year in Chicago, again, she's only shooting less than 1 3 a game, 29%. So I feel like, you know, in her WNBA career, she's been figuring out how she's going to get her shots. In this last year, she's done a great job. So let's talk about why she's such a great scorer. All right, I won't be talking too long because we got some clips that we got to watch. Great move. So one of the things that she does well and why she's such a great scorer is that she is a three-level scorer. She can hit the three, she can get to the mid-range, and she can get to the rim. All right, because she's so good at handling the ball, and especially in her college career, a lot of the offense was around her. So that's why I believe her three-point percentage was higher than in the W, because in the WNBA, they're not really game planning to get Carter her shots. But she's more than able to create her own shots off the dribble, and she's a great finisher around the rim, great flow game, and again, she can stop and pop for that mid-range game. So let's just watch her work. These are all March Madness highlights from her, and you'll see every bucket that she's getting, layup, midi, free. And she's, for the most part, creating those shots on her own. And of course, great defense, willing defender, which is necessary. I thought this game was really interesting because she's going up against Arike Ogunbowale, who is one of the best scorers in the WNBA currently. And at this time, I don't think people were really looking at Carter as the elite scorer that she was. And she really made her presence known in this game. Again, the elite ball handling, good hezo, get to the cup, lay. Man, she was cooking this game. And I think this is one of those games that really put her on the map. Well, I can't really say that. I mean, she's averaging what you see the ECAA tournament, 28 points a game. But I mean, Arike, I believe this game only scored, you know, 12, 14 points. So this was her statement game. You know, I am one of the best players in college basketball. Y'all gonna put some respect on my name. Yeah, I also want to point out, especially this game, she was scoring a lot off the pick and roll. Notice she gets a screen at half court, blows by one defender, takes the pull-up midi. She got a lot of great baskets off of the pick and roll, being able to read the screens and then read the help side defender. Just a great shot here. But in this possession, we get a screen. She noticed the defense is in deep drop coverage, so she takes the three. Again, just making simple reads and her ability to make shots is what makes her effective. Again, here, we get a double screen. She takes the first one, takes the second one. Notice that the defender doesn't get over the screen, right? Notices that the help is not there off of the screen. Shoot the shot. So she makes those reads off the pick and roll so well. And we see here another one. They get her the ball and, of course, get her another screen and roll downhill. So she's able to score very effectively off the pick and roll, which is why she's a great scorer. Thank you.